All praises unto the Most High YAH. I thank Him for your lives, and you are welcome. All right, guys, there's so much that's going on. There's so much that I want to speak to you about briefly. One of the things that I want to post right now is on the discussion of Black Americans, African Americans, however you identify yourselves, moving their money to Black banks, okay? And when I say there, I'm African American as well, Black American. But I'm speaking about those who are moving their money to Black-owned banks. Doesn't mean that I will not or do not currently hold an account with a Black-owned bank. And this is not against that. What I am wanting to do is to say, you know, great job, excellent job at wanting to have Black representation managing your money, okay, and that's a great thing. Others are doing it for various reasons, to show people that, hey, we don't have to do business with you, and I want to go somewhere where I'm respected. And for others, it's a part of the economic boycott that some people are have committed themselves to following. All right, so I'm not sure if it's an official economic boycott. For some people, it's just a statement of enough is enough. Right, and I think that's great if that's what you would like to do. Now, I do have people of various ethnicities on this channel, and you're welcome to share. But if you find that these shares are race baiting, or if you find the discussion of race uncomfortable, then you're not going to enjoy being on this channel, except when I'm speaking against the wrongs in the things that do not affect you or do not correct you. That's the thing, okay? Or that are not aimed to correct you, because it's up to you. It's up to me to make that decision to allow truth to correct us, okay? But I want to say to those of you who are doing it, who have already done it, or who currently may be holders of bank accounts in minority owned or minority ran banks, just want to say for to us, this is a share to let you know that it's important for us to educate ourselves, okay? Because when we are transferring money over to another bank and you're telling people, yeah, I'm banking with a Black-owned bank now, I'm taking my money out of, you know, the man's system, well, we have to get a clear understanding that the money is still in the man's system. And one of the things that we want to do is just, you know, even when you're speaking with someone and you're communicating with them, let them know that I am aware that this money is still in the system. I am aware that it's still ran by whom many call the man, all right? But educate yourself so that when eventually they do come out and say the joke is on Black Americans who've moved all their money because the banks that they're banking with are owned by a majority-owned white companies, be prepared for that, okay? And so one of the things that you can do is you can go to marketwatch.com, okay? Marketwatch.com. Now, I'm not going to name any of the banks, the Black-owned banks, but if you, before, pull up marketwatch.com, but before you do that, the bank that you are considering putting your money into, in quotations, search parent company of whatever the name of that bank is, okay? And so after a couple of Google searches, or perhaps in the first search, you're going to find the parent company of that bank. When you find the parent company of that bank, you're going to know who basically owns or controls the financial dealings and decisions of that bank, okay? Now, those that you see when in the bank when you go in there, those are the representatives of that bank, okay? And that actual facility, that bank may be 51% Black-owned, so to speak, all right? But when someone comes, let me just say this, when people come to put their money into a bank, money just doesn't go into the teller's drawer or into the vault. it is taken from there and put into a parent bank or another bank. For example, years ago, when I decided that I received an academic scholarship, and I decided, you know, I didn't want to go to school because the Lord was coming back soon, and, you know, it just didn't make any difference, you know, for me to go. And it's so much harder when you do decide to go back because life is there, and so you have to work around life now. But what we used to do when I worked at that bank many, many years ago is that we used to take our money, okay, and it was a savings and loans, a small bank, like many of the black-owned banks, okay, and we would take our daily deposits, and then we would take that and we would deposit it into our parent bank, which now would be, it's been bought several times, but today it's known as Wells Fargo, okay? So although we were a bank, we could make loans, we took CDs and made, you know, loans and all of these other things, we had a parent bank, and that parent bank was what is now called Wells Fargo. And so the shareholders of Wells Fargo pretty much controlled a lot of the financial decisions and investments that were made by that bank. So when you're moving your bank to a black-owned bank, make sure that you ask that branch manager, you ask that bank manager, who are the holders? Who is the parent company of this bank? Because the one thing you don't want to do is put your money into a bank with a company that has proven that they don't have your best interest at heart, that has a history of not lending money to minorities. If a bank is owned by X company, X banking company, and you know who they are, who have a history of not lending money to you, putting your money into a bank where the representatives are black and the officers at your local bank are black, but they still don't have the decision or the power to make the decisions on where the money is invested and who receives that money, we're going to find ourselves in the same situation. Okay, so just do your due diligence for your own benefit, and also when they come and say, aha, the joke is on you, you'll be knowledgeable of what actually happens when you put your money in any bank. All right, and that includes minority-ran bank. All right, I love you. Y'all bless you and have a wonderful day.